to read.
Yeah. Good afternoon, everyone. Shall we start the next session? Yeah, guys. Welcome to the DrupalCon Amsterdam. This is my first DrupalCon ever, and I am speaking on the digital transformation from print, paper to news and media with Drupal. Sure. So this is a small introduction about me. This is Marina Vincent. I am standing in front of it. I'm working with Drupal since 2012, and I'm working with Singapore Press Holding as a technical lead. This is my Drupal.org profile ID. You can reach me out of there. Talking about my recent work, I have recently developed a thinkchina.sg, is a news portal built in Drupal 8. We use cloud, we use containerized architecture, we use a blue and green deployment process. And yeah, we tried every our best to match with the real world. Speaking about the SPH, we are now celebrating the 35 years this year, and we have around 2.4 million readers across 18 global newspapers, more than 900K copies per day, more than 4K staff employees across 3 centers in Singapore, and 8 news bureaus overseas. We have more than 500 plus ad partners located at different places across the globe. Speaking about the servers, we have more than 2,200 on-premise servers, which is including Unix, IBM Cloud, IBM and mainframes and Windows. We have 150 plus cloud servers, which is hosted on AWS and GCP. Yeah, to manage all the shops, we have around more than 250 tech employees. Looking into some of the products of SPH, the street times, which is having the highest reach across the Singapore, which is having the more audience base, the street times and the Sunday times. We have the Chinese news publication, which is Zaobao, Wanbao and Xinbin. We have Tamil news publication, which is Tamil Morasu, and we also have Malay language publication, the Baritarian. The Tabla, which is more focused into Indian news, and we have a centralized news bank which provides the data to the external clients. So we have the news links system as well. Let's look at the numbers of the straight times, which is having 800K prints, daily print readers, more than 2.8 million unique visits monthly, more than 30 million pages views monthly, and average spend time per user is 2.5 minutes. Looking at the another news web publication, the Zaobao, which is having 386K news print papers daily, which includes Zaobao, Wanbao and Xinbin. We have 750K monthly unique visitors on the Zaobao site, 14 million pages viewed per month, and average time spent by per user is 4 minutes. Zaobao is also accessible in the China, so we have Zaobao.com, which is the numbers are great, more than this compared to this. Now, let's look like where from the digital transformation point of view, where we need the transformation, which are the areas we can focus on and we can improve on it. So now the editors, there is a new definitions of the editorial products. The editorials are very smart enough nowadays. They require new features each and every day to publish the news articles, and they need new features and every. So they ask for auto tagging of the images, they ask the auto tagging of the articles, they ask the content recommendations, which is auto served. So there is a scope of transformation in that field as well. So the each and every editor as well as the user should be having the product expertise, and there is scope of analytical enhancement where we can have a real time dashboard of which article is trending more, which article is poorly performed by each and every editors. We can show the dashboard with the real-time data. Based on the real data, we can suggest the We can suggest the articles to the latest trending articles. The technological enhancements, as we saw yesterday in the Drupal initiatives, there is a much more initiatives in the workflow, workspace, front-end configuration management, everything. That's why we use Drupal. We feel Drupal is the best solution for our news and website, news media publications. From the customer point of view, why there is a need of the digital transformation? So customer is continuously looking for the opportunities to experience media uniquely tailored and tailored for their own personal preferences, contexts, and schedules. So the consumers are never idle, and they are mobile, and they watch their, they need greater control of how and when they need to experience the media. This is a very classic example. In the previous ancient days, a family of four used to watch pictures or movies together. But nowadays, each and every user have their own preferences and choice. A father wants to see different news channels, a mother wants to see different channels, serials, while kids used to see movies or cartoons, etc. So there is a much more scope based on the personalization and based on the user data. We can do digital transformation. Let's look at the numbers, how digital transformation is much needed. This is the global survey done by PwC, where we can see the average CAGR is increasing from 4.3% within next 5 years in news and media companies. So this is the projected numbers by PwC. Talking about the globally, the revenue of digital in news and media is 53.1% in 2018, while compared to 2019, it is continuously steadily growing up from 55 to 57 till 61 is the projected score by PwC. So 61.6% of global revenue, of total revenue, is under comes under digital from the digital revenues. Let's go into more deeper into the details. These are the projected numbers percentage for the next 5 years. We can see the news and consumer magazines are declining for next 5 years, whereas internet marketing, OTT videos, and VR is continuously growing for next 5 years. So we're more focused into digital advertising and internet marketing. Some more insights on the news consumptions of age-wise and device-wise by survey done for in 10 different countries for more than 2,000 people. We can clearly see the smartphone users are having the high numbers and desktop, and the print media is continuously declining. As we already heard in today's Drisnot, there is a huge increase in globally internet access from 20 million to 300 billion till 2030. So we can see the scope of news consumption digitally is very, very much important. Let's look at the numbers, into the numbers of how SPH is performing. This is a comparison of print versus digital. The daily average print of straight times is declining from 2017 to 2018. And we can see every publications, the digital numbers are increasing while the print numbers are declining. So in order to get the digital audience, consume the digital customers, at the start of this year, what we have done is, in order to engage the customers, we have launched a Samsung news tablet, which will provide the e-papers, inbuilt e-papers. Customer don't need to download the e-papers. And they just need to log in into their Samsung tablet, and then they can get the access to the e-papers which they are subscribed monthly or yearly. So this is how our marketing team is engaging audience and gathering the customers very more frequently to increase the digital revenues. So talking about the digital, how digital transformation would be helpful in terms of news and media. So it would be more helpful into content planning, like we can get the audience data, what they are what form of data they read, they access, and we can suggest the customer audience that we can recommend the articles related to their own preferences. We can provide a better UI look and feel. We can provide in on-site and in-app readers access. We can provide subscription and pricing promotions. We provide different paywall messages, show different paywall messages for different users. Users of different countries will should see different paywall messages. We use the data to understand the reader attention span and retention to drive lifetime values. There is a scope of revenue diversification, so to develop the non-core products and service using the reader insights and the behavior. Talking about how Drupal is making an impact in SPH, how we use Drupal, and based on the news and media publications, how Drupal is making an impact. All the major publications of SPH digitally are powered by Drupal. Right now they are in Drupal 7, but we are planning to migration of Drupal 8 and on cloud. Drupal is working as a backbone for all the mobile apps. There is a continuous seamless integration from print article paper to the Drupal website. So the articles which are printed on the physical copies are also published on our website. And there is a continuous seamless integration, so it can be real-time or it can be on cron jobs. All the major websites are responsive. More the audience of Drupal websites are from the mobile, so yeah, they are responsive. We have different languages publications, and we support multilingual websites. We have some microsites for Zhaobao. We have small projects for Belt and Road China. So we build a microsite for them, and we are planning to go with a multi-tenant architecture to have a same code base, and how each publication will access the same editorial behavior, which we'll see and discuss later on. Yeah, this is how responsive website. If you get a chance to look into zhaobao.sg, this is a responsive website for it. So this is the print article flow, which flows into Drupal. There is a print editorial system where editors creates an article into their editorial system, which get published into the physical paper, which in turn the article flows into Drupal, and Drupal in turn which serves into the website, mobile app. We have Google AMP pages, we integrated a Facebook instance article. We have some external clients as well, and so basically we there are some external vendors which wants access to Drupal articles on monthly or yearly basis. So we provide external subscription model on monthly or yearly basis, so they can consume our articles from Drupal. We provide newsletters as well to retain the customers, to get the daily news articles to their emails. It's also powered by Drupal. This is a three-step custom model built in Drupal, where editors can select the template and pick the content what they want to send out over the email, and then check how it looks like before sending it to the actual users. So they can select the content templates, they can select the which content they want to send to the end user, and after selecting this, this is how the email template will look before sending. So when they click on send email, it will go to the send test users, and after confirming, we can send them to the actual users. We also target so there are two newsletters, the daily morning and the evening. So we also target the more users which haven't access to morning newsletters. We target them differently to see the evening newsletters. This is the most amazing feature right now we have developed, which is single sign-on. Let's say there are two different publications, one is Straight Times and other is Business Times. So when the user is logged in into, so user is subscribed to Straight Times but not to Business Times. So when user is logged in into Straight Times, and when he goes to Business Times, he don't need to log in. So based on the user behavior on the Straight Times, we track the user behavior, which articles he watched, which categories he used to prefer, and how much time he spends. Using the GA, our plan is to provide the content recommendations on all the different publications of all the SPH publications. So if I go to Business Times, I am a Business Times subscriber, and I watch the stock news, and again I go to Straight Times, I can see the content recommendations related to stocks at the below of the articles. This is the most amazing feature, which is content recommendations, which works differently from what I talked previously. So on the home page, we have two different sections where we have set content recommendation. It's based on the user location, based on the user behavior, based on user average time span. So we on the every page refresh, it will show different articles. Unlike this, so every time they won't see the same article daily. Talking about the dynamic paywalls, so at the all the some of the articles are premium articles. So we show them a message at the end of the articles in order to subscribe. In order to see the full articles, you need to subscribe or log in. But the message which is shown at the bottom of the articles are different for all the users. It can be different for different devices, different for different countries, and different for different types of users. Talking about the Dream CMS, yeah. So we have all the Drupal 7 websites. It's on in-house, on-premise servers. So idea, our plan is to migrate to Drupal 8 first, to cloud then Drupal 8. And so as it is news and media, there is a lots of bot attacks or daily going on, so we want to prevent them. There's lots of redundant work going. So let's say there is a Straight Times and there is a Zauba. There's lots of redundant work when we say. So if we do a GA implementation on Zauba, same needs to be done on Straight Times. But different users and different developers spend different times to do the same task, which increase our workloads. We want to decrease that. And right now the editorial system is different and Drupal system is different. We want to make it one. This is the architecture of how our Drupal Dream CMS, what we have planned for. We can see there is a Drupal core and contributed modules, which will work same for all the publications, which is there are some Drupal custom modules, which is also common for all the publications. So we put them into a separate Git repo. There is a separate Git repo for dedicated custom and patches for each publications. We will use the composer to fetch the latest data from each Git repos, and each publication would have the same code base, same Drupal instance, but it's a totally different instance. Yeah, keeping it very short, that's all. If you have any questions, you can reach me on, and this is my Drupal.org ID, and you can find my slides on this URL.
There's maybe time for one urgent question. Oh, you don't have to use that.
Yeah, okay. Could you describe a bit more how you use the content relay creation engine, recommendation engine?
This one?
Yes.
So we There are two ways we do it right now. We have integrated with the CSense and Handshake. So there are two different CSense, yeah. So there are two different companies. We integrate the JavaScript into our system. They track the user behavior, and based on that data, it shows dynamically every time.
So it's not an integration in the
system? It's not right now, but our plan is to do that.
Okay, well, thank you very much.